1 point has been awarded.
Let's go!
To Team Corbin and Ryan. I like the attitude. Welcome to the ultimate WrestleMania 4 Sunday. I am Sam Roberts, and I am here with two great superstars, one-time commissioners of the Ultimate Show. They are the Wolf Dogs, Bron Breakker, and Baron Corbin, but those aren't the only two that are with me, because I got a couple other hosts with me, of course, as they are on every Ultimate Show. Ryan Pappolla.
That's right.
Kaz Famuyide.
Massively good zoom out. Yes, sir, guys. Love it.
And I'm going to tell you, today's a very special Ultimate Show, because you know what we do here on the Ultimate Show. We craft the ultimate dream card and then see what would happen if it might actually happen. But today is different. Let's start the clock. 60 minutes. WrestleMania is all about competition.
I got it.
And so today, we're going to make it a competition. This couch right here, that's one team. This couch right here
is going to win.
Easily.
Oh, come on now.
Easily.
That's another team. I already love the stakes are here, and we are going to play the ultimate game of the Ultimate Show. Let's take a look at the rules. Both teams are going to craft a WrestleMania card of all of our dreams. Each team is going to receive a roster of 20 superstars that the powers that be have selected. From their rosters, each team must create three matches, one being a singles, one a triple threat, and one a tag team match. Two additional singles matches will be created. This is where the teamwork amongst all of us come into play, as these two additional singles matches will be head-to-head matches, one member of each roster from each team. Okay. The final card will consist of seven matches. I know you're saying, how does that math work out? I'll get back to it. Each team is going to be able to steal one roster from the other team. I'll get back to how. One member of the roster. Thank you very much, Baron Corbin. And each team gets to assign one stipulation to one of their matches. And what if you don't want a stipulation to one of your matches? Well,
too bad.
That may cost you. Because the points are going to be contingent.
What's it say?
I don't know what
confused.
It says.
I'm confused. But it's all good. It's
just
all
follow good. My lead.
I'm following your lead. We're
going to Cuz I haven't told
I
you how this
you.
I appreciate that. The scoring is what's important here. Yes. That's why the rules are important, because of the stakes of this game. There's going to be 1 point for the best team name. There's going to be 1 point for the best steal. I told you there'd be a period where you could each steal one member of the other team's roster. 1 point for the best three-match card that either team is able to create. 1 point for the best stipulation. So if you don't do a stipulation, you've just sacrificed a point. That would be insane.
You're
1 point for the winner of the head-to-head matchup, meaning whoever wins, that team will get a point. 1 point for whichever team main events the ultimate WrestleMania 4 Sunday. And if you are the team with the match that doesn't make this card, that eighth match, your team will lose 1 point. And I know a lot of you are confused.
There's a chance we could not be on the card? We could be left home?
Well, there's eight matches.
I feel like a lot of these decisions are going to be made by like one central body. Is that what I'm gathering?
Ryan, I'm glad you asked. There's one more thing we should keep in mind with the scoring. All points will be decided by Sam Roberts. The powers that be.
Oh, you're on the graphic.
The powers that be thought
that
this was way to go. The powers that be thought this was the way to go.
I love how you went for the Jet Beauty of the Week, sort of like the hand Sam pose a little bit.
Okay, I would like to say, before we even name the teams, 1 point has been awarded.
Let's go!
To Team Corbin and Ryan. I like the attitude. We're going to go ahead and put 1 point down.
This is exciting. We're up one.
We're going to give you a chance to tie the game because right now is the time to name our teams. Whichever team name is better, according to the judge, gets a point. So since Ryan and Baron Corbin are already in the lead, with 1 point. I'm first going to go to Kaz and Bron Breakker. Kaz and Bron Breakker.
Got it.
What is the name of your team?
So Bron and I have deliberated for a minute, and we're going to go with Team Beef Dogs.
Beef Dogs.
Beefy Dogs. Let's go.
Beef.
Whole lot of beef. That's right. Whole lot of dog. Gonna be a great show.
The Beef Dogs. Yeah. Beef Dogs.
Follow that.
Ryan, you can't take the
Kaz,
beef
please,
over there.
We're deliberating, Kaz. I didn't interrupt you. Yeah.
Well,
okay. You guys are getting 3 point for nothing. Yeah. So go ahead.
I mean, I don't know if that attitude is healthy for to get points.
I didn't know Sam could
fall off. That attitude's not helping.
But Mr. Hamilton and Mr. Lincoln, I didn't think that was...
We're already up one. Worst case.
Beef Dogs versus...
We are the Wolf Pups.
What?
The Wolf Pups.
Stupidest name I've ever heard.
No!
The Wolf
Pups.
If Ryan could pull off a convincing bark.
The Wolf Pups.
No,
I will concede.
I can't do this. Point. We've already established.
I will concede the point if Ryan could give a convincing bark.
Ladies and gentlemen,
right now.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Beef Dogs get a point.
Let's go.
The Beef Dogs get an easy right. point on that one. Easy
you
point.
You hear me bark?
On that one, I'd prefer not to, honestly. I gave them the point to
Fair
avoid
enough.
Hearing that bark. It's now time to find out the rosters yes. that we'll
back
be
zero.
Working
back
with.
Back to zero.
Wolf Pups, here is your roster.
Thanks, Sam.
You can share. Beef you. Dogs.
That's right.
There is your roster. These are the rosters that we'll be working with, and we'd like to show the people at home.
Yep.
These are the names that the Beef Dogs and the Wolf
loaded.
Pups
are
going to be working with. These are the names.
I like that as a match.
Ryan, when you say I like that,
yeah.
Ryan, Baron Corbin, what are some of the names that quickly jump out at you when you think about WrestleMania memories? Who are you happy about that's on your list?
I mean, off rip, both Baron and I both kind of highlighted Razor Ramon. Obviously, you think of the ladder match, especially on a WrestleMania 40-year, 30th anniversary of the ladder match itself, but several other great WrestleMania memories as well. And so I think that creates a lot of intriguing possibilities for matchups that we can create, but I am worried about the steal.
And by the way, good place for a stipulation.
Sure.
That could be a point winner. What about you guys? What about you, Beef Dogs?
You know, there's been this trend on TikTok for a while that I've sort of taken to heart. It's called "We Done with the 90s."
Ooh.
All right, we done with the 90s. We got love for the 90s. We got love for the old school. We got love for history. But we're all about creating an ultimate show that also ultimately leads to the future and leads to the now and leads to that. So I think we're gonna do a little bit of that. Obviously, always show love to the past, but you know as well. We got the future right next to me, right here. You feel me? Like, it's all about, we always want to talk about who he's related to.
Unfortunately, that future is not on your roster.
I mean,
you are not on your own roster here.
Well, you know, he's on our roster. I mean, you can make a very convincing argument to get on the roster if you'd like to.
This is a rigged game from the get-go. He's on the cover of the rules. Let's get it going.
Let's go, man. We got this. We're going to make this work.
That's very good to know. What about, is there anybody, there are celebrities on both of your lists?
Yes.
Are there any celebrities that you look at and go like, ooh, that's somebody I can work with?
So,
I mean, is Logan Paul a celebrity still, or is he a full?
Great
question. It's a good hybrid, you know. So we have that. That's a good one in my book.
And somebody's made a huge impact on WrestleMania.
Yeah,
totally.
Exactly.
Already multiple.
Multiple WrestleManias. Yeah.
I mean, we got a person who, you know, just handed out an Oscar in Bad Bunny.
And John Cena.
And John
Cena. You have two.
John Cena.
We got a lot of Oscar buzz on our list of people over here.
That's strong in wrestling.
You know, you got to get the kids. You got to get the people's attention. And John Cena got a lot of attention at the Oscars this year. I feel like if you have an ultimate WrestleMania moment, we got to do something to top that.
Well,
we
got to
do something to top.
You got to top John Cena at the Oscars?
We got to top Naked Cena somehow. And we got Bad Bunny in there. I think we'll put our heads together, make something happen.
You've got so many WrestleMania main eventers on your roster alone. You've got Batista. You've got Bret Hart. You've got John Cena. You've got Roddy Piper, Stone Cold Steve Austin, Triple H, Yokozuna.
Yes.
One of my favorites.
We're going headliners only, man. Everybody on our list has a moment in WrestleMania history that really stands out through the test of time. So I don't think there's a way we can go wrong here.
And I think you also have to think about, this is something you guys should be thinking about. Don't forget about the head-to-head. If there's somebody on your list that you think can beat somebody on their list.
So really, someone that we think you like better than most people.
That wouldn't be. That would maybe if I didn't have the integrity that I have.
Sure.
Sure, but look who you've got. You've got Macho Man Randy Savage. You've got AJ Styles. You've got Becky Lynch.
Yeah.
CM Punk is on your list.
We've already mentioned Punk's name several times.
Shawn Michaels.
Yeah.
I mean, this
is an all-star roster.
This is an all-star roster. And look.
I mean, it's all right.
I will say, you've got The Undertaker.
Like, it ain't, you know.
The Undertaker is on your list.
Yeah.
I mean, that's
an embarrassment of riches.
I mean, you could go Shawn Taker and just, it's one of the greatest matches of all time. Oh. We already know that.
Your spin on Shawn Taker? I mean, that's fun.
Oh, you're flattering.
Yeah.
I like that. Is there anybody, Bron Breakker, that you look at when you look at the list of the wolf pups and go, ah, I wish they were on my list?
I feel like Roman Reigns or The Undertaker are both, you know, we might... We might have to have a steal or
you are going to get the opportunity.
Yeah, we do get a steal.
I do think we have some tradable assets on our team.
Yeah, we might have to make a trade or something.
Not a trade, it's
we can
a
negotiate.
Steal.
We can. You guys want
to? You know what I think? I think it's time to cement these lists.
And the
only way we can cement these lists is to get past the steal period.
Oh, we're going to start out with a steal.
It's also going to be worth 1 point for best steal, depending on what the judges think, of course. Since you guys scored first, I'm going to give you guys the Beef Dogs, the first steal. You each get one steal. The Beef Dogs are going to get the first steal. This is big.
We're locked in.
Beef Dogs. Beef Dogs, who are you taking?
Beef Dogs select Roman.
Give me that.
Roman Reigns.
Snatchies.
That was a good snatch. That could be points.
The greatest of all time. Who's better, honestly?
Oh, like, I acknowledge there's
legitimately, like, but that's
but
the ceiling.
But who can compliment someone on
ceiling.
Our match?
That's the top. Okay, I mean, so if we win this section. This is just.
You're saying there's nobody that they can
there
take.
There isn't.
Nope. Wow. Light word. Easy word.
Wow. Now, what do you guys think? What are the wolf pups?
Oh, I love that.
What are the wolf pups?
I love that.
All right. We just, we've decided we are stealing Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Yep. Oh, my goodness.
Shatter the glass, Kaz.
Listen.
Bang, bang.
Wow.
What did I say when we started
I'm breaking the limit inside you.
You know what? It's okay, because we're done with the 90s today, all right? You can have Stone Cold Steve Austin. We're looking towards the present and the future.
That's a good point.
That's a tough one.
It's a tough one.
I say, honestly, I say we like rate it.
So listen, we're done with the 90s.
Listen, we have to figure out what the best deal was.
Okay.
And I've got to tell you, Stone Cold Steve Austin might be...
Go ahead.
My favorite.
Let's hear your argument. My as favorite. To why yours is better than
Stone
ours.
Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Yeah, listen. Sure.
He got, arguably the greatest of all time. He got his own title, the Smoking Skull title.
You know, you used a very specific word there. Arguably the greatest of all time.
Arguably. There is no argument on our side.
Men lie,
it's
women
Roman
lie.
Reigns.
And numbers don't lie,
you know
brother.
What Sam's gonna do
Come
here.
On now.
He's been champion for.
No, there's a reason. When people ask who's on the Mount Rushmore, Steve is always up there. Roman is not there.
His
career's not over.
He's main evented nine. How many WrestleManias?
Nine.
WrestleManias.
Okay, but
you can have Mount Rushmore. We're building up.
Stone Cold's also got a movie career going on. He's got several TV shows.
Somebody hasn't seen Hobbs and Shaw.
a movie career's more than one.
Okay.
And I'll tell you what.
Also, his own beer.
Yeah, he does have
podcast,
an IPA.
A guy podcast. After your own heart, a podcast guy.
I do love podcasts.
I think you need to think about this, Sam.
I am thinking a lot about it. And
full package.
Roman Reigns is in Fast and the Furious.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Hobbs and Shaw.
Hobbs and Shaw is a great flex.
Fast and
his family's the most famous family, arguably, on Earth.
Come on,
the
man.
Rock.
Yeah,
I get it.
We're not talking The Rock.
Yeah,
here.
Man.
The NYE,
you know what you
Maya mean. Via Samoan Dynasty does speak for itself.
The bloodline.
Stone Cold Steve Austin has so many attributes, but all those attributes that you just listed, they're outside the ring, and we don't go outside the ring.
Hey.
At the Ultimate WrestleMania.
Outside the ring, man.
Roman Reigns is
the guy's
the greatest
Roman
steal.
Reigns. The pack in the bloodline.
That you could possibly do. Roman Reigns, very smart.
That's right.
Bron knows ball, bro.
Kaz knew what he was doing.
That's it.
Point for ball. Kaz knew what you were doing.
There's nothing we could have done. Two for them Beef Dogs. Now it's time to book this card. Where do we want to begin? Do you have a proposition for a head-to-head? Or would you guys like to propose a match that you'd like to put on the card?
I mean, who? Before I say it out loud.
I'm feeling pretty good about that.
All right. We're going to keep brainstorming, Sam. We do have a proposal. We have an official proposal for our singles match. For the Wolf
singles match.
For the Wolf Pup singles match, if that's okay at this
please,
point.
Please, give it to me.
All right.
The Wolf Pup singles match.
The Wolf Pups propose CM Punk.
Okay.
Versus the man we stole, Stone Cold Steve Austin.
I'm not a fan. I'm not.
Let's go!
What's our triple threat?
Are you ready to throw it on the board?
I'm ready to throw it on the board.
Throw it on the board. They're doing it. The Wolf Pups, first match of WrestleMania, singles match.
What?
Is CM Punk versus Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Okay.
I think our triple could be here.
Okay, you're considering our triple threat. Have you considered any matches?
For the one-on-one.
Any of them. You could do one-on-one.
Headlining WrestleMania.
I will decide the main event.
Okay.
Bron, take it away. You got this, man. You got this. It's a big joint.
This is what we got.
Okay.
Our singles match is going to be Roman Reigns versus Triple H.
Ooh, never before seen.
And by the way, the single most handsome main event in Ultimate WrestleMania history.
We've seen it in Dallas. We've seen it in one way.
Yeah, we saw
it. This is a different
way. Yeah, but this is a different time.
The Ultimate version. I can't argue it. It's a great match.
We're talking
right?
Ultimate
this
Triple
H. This is fantasy booking, right?
I just feel like I've seen it. I'm just going with that.
I just feel like
I gotta tell you,
there's nothing that's topping those two. You know what I mean?
There's a lot of power.
Imagine Triple H's. Okay. Triple H's entrance for that show.
We're talking in the ring here.
Imagine his current entrance. Yeah, what it would be.
Yeah. Our ruler.
Harley Davidson, green smoke, motorcycles.
Oh, I love motorcycles.
Coolest stuff ever. Skulls.
Stone Cold could drive a beer truck to the ring.
Roman Reigns.
He could drive a beer truck. That was awesome.
Yeah, that'll run your little motorcycles over.
It would run the motorcycles over. An 18-wheeler. So have you thought about a triple threat match?
We have a triple threat.
You already do.
We have a triple threat, and we have a stipulation for our triple threat.
Have you thought about adding a stipulation to Roman Reigns and Triple H, or is that something you'd rather keep?
We're going to keep
that in
our back pocket.
We're going to save it.
You can always add a stipulation later.
Okay.
Triple threat.
Wolf Pups, what are you thinking for a triple threat?
Do you say it out loud? Yeah, I think we're basically ready to lock it in.
Now, keep in mind, by the way.
Yeah.
Any of these superstars that you pick for your matches right now, you won't have the option of putting them in a head-to-head match.
Okay.
We're okay with that.
Our roster is loaded. For our triple threat.
Yes.
We mentioned it earlier, WrestleMania 10. We talked about how Razor Ramon was someone we highlighted quickly.
Yes.
We're going to pay tribute to WrestleMania 10 by starting our triple threat with Shawn versus Razor.
Yes.
Adding AJ Styles and making that a ladder match for the Ultimate Intercontinental Championship.
What?
That's what we're doing, Sam Roberts.
Wow.
I didn't hear that.
That's what we're doing.
You already got Razor and Shawn to have one of the greatest ladder matches of all time. So now we're adding AJ Styles.
We have Shawn, Razor, AJ Styles, triple threat ladder match for the Ultimate Intercontinental Championship.
Let's love to see that match, Bron Breakker. You'd love to see
Sam,
that
can we just get the point right now?
Look at his face. He doesn't even know what to say.
That's a tough one.
Thank you.
I've got to tell you, there's going to be a point awarded for best set of three matches, and right now,
we're kicking your
those two. Austin versus Punk,
our girls match.
Ladder match.
Match,
Shawn Michaels, Razor Ramon, AJ Styles. By the way, at WrestleMania, you know what Shawn does at WrestleMania.
You know
what do you guys think?
I find it disrespectful that you guys have left The Undertaker out.
Wow, that is
he's
very,
on your team?
Yeah, that is very
disrespectful. Yeah, man.
Head-to-head.
You got to pick one off your roster to face us in a head-to-head.
The Undertaker. That's just unbelievable, man. Put him in a tag.
Just because you're on SmackDown now and you're trying to kiss Hunter's butt.
Wow. Oh, my gosh.
Whoa. I want to take that Bazoo.
It's getting hot in here.
Okay. You know, he's like, I'm on SmackDown. All right, Roman Reigns, best ever. Triple H, come on, boss. Put me over.
Oh, my gosh.
All right.
Okay. Things are getting tense.
Stay on your couch.
That's epic.
Damn. Look at that. Look at that 1-2 graphics right there.
And it's just such a good vest.
I'm saying take
all my money. It's such a great vest.
I should bring that back for a match.
I think you should.
It'd be a mistake not to.
SummerSlam the vest and do a Razor.
Great pattern.
Yeah. Gotcha. Okay.
Okay. Are we? What do we have? I see you said got it.
Take it away.
So that's how good we are.
WrestleMania has always been about the faces of the company, the people that people have paid hard-earned money to see.
Showcase of the Immortals.
That's right. And in our roster, we got three people in the past, the just finished present, and the present future, as far as being a triple threat, and leading this company as the faces of the company. So we're going to have a triple threat match.
Okay.
The franchise, John Cena.
Oh, boy.
Versus the excellence of execution, Bret the Hitman Hart, versus the American Nightmare, Cody Rhodes.
Oh, my goodness.
In a first ever triple threat Iron Man match, first to win all the pinfalls, all the submissions, wins the triple threat.
How long is the Iron Man match?
We're going 30 minutes? We're going 30 minutes. We're not doing the hour.
It's very generous. It's a loaded card. Very generous.
It's a loaded card. It's ultimate.
How are we feeling over there? Nervous? You
know? No.
Great match.
It's a 30-minute Iron Man.
Nervous.
Now, we've never had a triple threat Iron Man match before, right?
No.
Now, there's the possibility.
There's a reason for that.
Obviously. There's always. But, hey, even one-on-one Iron Man matches have ended in ties before.
Let's just remind everybody that they left The Undertaker out in your fantasy book. Looking here, The Undertaker has been left out.
That's an inaccurate portrayal.
The Undertaker has been left out.
It has inaccurate portrayal.
We have seven matches booked.
We're just following the rules and regulations.
The Undertaker
has laid out.
You'll only see our tag.
You'll do three.
Oh, God.
And then two head to head.
Yeah, our head to head.
Where we're already on our second head to head.
Very interesting, by the way.
They're nervous, man. A lot of talking going on over there. Nervous.
Trying to convince themselves.
Yeah, I find it very interesting that you both chose the triple threat for the stipulation match, but it could be very, very good. Tag match.
We're ready.
We have it.
We're ready.
We have it.
Wait, who won?
Would you like it? No, we do this at the end, then, Brainiac.
That's not his name.
Okay, all right.
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay, so our tag match.
Yes.
Is going to be Rhea.
Ooh.
And China.
Dream team.
That is a dream team.
Thank you.
You don't have to shout.
Sorry.
Versus Becky and Trish.
Rivals have also teamed together at a past Mania, back together.
And it's that generational thing.
Yeah.
Generational.
Yeah. On each side. History there.
That's a huge tag team match. That is a enormous ultimate WrestleMania tag team match. Rhea Ripley and Chyna versus Becky Lynch and Trish Stratus. And you'd probably see the softer side of Trish Stratus as Rhea Ripley and Chyna just became these absolute menaces.
Fan favorite Trish, for sure. Favorite Trish, for sure.
Yeah, maybe it starts with Chyna and Rhea.
You're already in this.
Oh, you got?
That's how good this is.
Because maybe they're driving Trish insane. They keep beating her down, and the man eventually comes out to save Trish.
A newfound respect after their battles. Yeah. And
leads us to where we're at.
A newfound respect between Becky and Trish after their 2023 battles. There's a lot there.
There's history.
Now, if you're not ready, Team Beef Dogs, for a tag match necessarily, you could, of course, also pitch a head-to-head.
Well, we know who you got left.
I'm gonna let you.
Okay.
I picked the first two, so you take the second team.
All right. Okay.
We'll just let it.
Bet. Let's make this happen. All right. We're gonna put together our star-studded sort of tag team match right here. Right.
Yeah. Oh, look at that graphic. Look at Chyna and Rhea Ripley versus Becky Lynch and Trish Stratus.
I feel great about it.
You're welcome, world.
I mean, it could be a Mount Rushmore.
I gotta be honest.
It could be a Mount Rushmore.
Yeah, absolutely.
We should probably go.
It's making them rethink.
That was a.
Sent them back to the drawing board. It's that good.
Do you feel comfortable just awarding us the point for the three right now?
Well, listen, I do not feel comfortable. And I do want you guys to recognize something, too. Kaz, while you're strategizing, if I could.
Yes.
Keep in mind that when I put together this card, if the matches are too similar, I'm only going to take one. Do we really want a WrestleMania with two triple threat matches? Do we really want a WrestleMania with two women's tag matches? Maybe, but it could be a risk. Could be a risk, guys. If it's too similar, it could be a risk.
Okay.
I'm not doing it. Had to pick a triple.
No, he's just saying.
Okay. Thus far, the Undertaker's not even on the card for your guys' list. I just want to point that out.
That's offensive.
The Undertaker is not even on their card.
Are you just keep bringing
the Undertaker
because you want someone to talk about how the time he chokes on you?
Unbelievable.
He did
disrespect.
Andre the Giant isn't on your card.
Yeah. Hey, we're saving him. We're saving him.
Well, that's what.
Okay.
All right.
Okay. All right. You stay over there then. All right. So. Bam, all right?
Sami Zayn's not on your board yet.
Well, how do you not know we had something planned for Sami?
That just wait.
It's still being worked out at the moment.
But okay.
In any case, I think we have two options here, right?
So, okay.
Sam, we're gonna talk this out.
You're workshopping in real time?
This is great. I love workshopping.
Workshopping in real time.
You know I love that. Right?
We're on a time clock here.
Now, like
just
I said,
so you're aware.
Sam, well, we've seen Sam work under pressure before. He's got plenty of time.
I appreciate that, Kaz.
So, of course.
That seemed a little pandering.
Not to me. It didn't to me. Don't even worry about that.
Let's give it. We're not nervous.
We're not nervous here, okay? So I think as much as we love everything we have so far.
You keep bringing up Taker, too. You could have stole him.
We could have.
Really? So technically, you don't have the respect for Taker. Either.
Oh, really?
You could have.
Really?
Been, like,
you guys didn't even put him in a match, and he's on your squad. Don't try to turn this on me.
And the guy we stole beat him at WrestleMania.
What's going on?
Not a lot of people.
What's going on, dude?
It ain't disrespectful. That's the truth.
Seems a little disrespectful to the dead man, Cass.
The truth is not disrespectful.
You've done it now. You've gone and made a big mistake.
You got nothing else. You're done.
Team Beef Dogs, like I said, our motto is we're done with the 90s, right? But we still got respect for the 90s. We still got love for
it. Doesn't sound like it from what you've been talking
about. We do. But you're going to see where we're going once you put this
match. All right, man.
On one side, we're going to have the legend side, right? We're going to have Lita and Alondra Blaze on one side. Two women who have made a ton of history.
You know, I like Alondra Blaze.
Love you some Alondra Blaze, Sam. And on the other side, we're going with two women who have defined the women's generation right now in Bianca Belair and Charlotte Flair. All right? That's the matchup right there. Four real groundbreakers in the women's It wasn't like it was an audible or anything like that. I'm just saying.
You didn't have to pick women and follow our lead.
That seems like a weird sentence to say after we make our women's tag match.
You just happened to go first.
It doesn't feel like it was an audible or anything.
We just happened to go first. That has nothing to do with when we were
going to put this card in. He's got his eraser on his pencil.
Why is there all that eraser dust on your page?
This is not eraser dust. This is just dust from how fast I've been writing.
Let's see the graphic.
Look
at the star power.
Okay. And then it also begs the question: when you get to Charlotte and Bianca Belair, can they coexist?
Can they coexist?
It's a little added intrigue in that match. You do have to admit it's a little added intrigue.
Of course, this is the ultimate version of each of these competitors. So we're getting prime Alondra Blaze, prime Lita, who is. And if you think about prime Lita against like Bianca, Charlotte, Alondra Blaze, strength, high flying, not only is there star power here, but there is also real technical wizardry between the four of these women.
They're wizards.
The chemistry is a lot.
How does Alondra feel that you keep insulting the 90s and you put, like, how does that work?
How does the Undertaker feel not even being on the card?
Probably worse. Probably fair, much worse.
Fair question.
Before we get to the head-to-head.
We respect the 90s, but we're done with it.
Four mania. Yeah. So you're not going to get much of a build.
Okay.
Oh, we're getting tons of build.
I don't know what he's talking about. I don't know.
What did you say?
I don't know what he's talking about.
Stupid.
He says all kinds of stuff, and sometimes it's crazy.
Listen,
but I think it's time. This is big, okay? We're looking at our three matches from each team. And as you know, 1 point is awarded for the best three matches.
Mm-hmm.
And I've got to tell you, that Roman Reigns and Triple H graphic, oh, does that look handsome? Look at the physiques on those guys, huh? John Cena, Bret Hart, Cody Rhodes together
the
in
Iron
one
Man
ring.
Match for the heart of the WWE Universe. Can you think of more beloved figures between John Cena, Bret Hart, and Cody Rhodes?
Why would you put the audience through that? Making them pick between their three favorites for 30 minutes.
Listen.
Well, sometimes that is intriguing.
Is all about
30 minutes.
The same thing can be said for Punk and Austin. Why would you put them through that?
Yeah, facts.
He's right.
We don't know if it's clobbering time or we want to drink beer. What do we do?
That was a great retort. Before I give a point for the best three matches, I'm going to give a point for the best stipulation.
Okay, what we got?
I've seen ladder matches before.
Oh, come on.
Yeah.
I love ladder matches.
Set them up, Sam. Set them up to knock them down, baby. Set them up to knock them down.
A 30-minute Iron Man match, triple threat.
Never been done.
For a reason.
Kaz, the Beef Dog's a point for best stipulation.
Let's go.
Got any more 20s?
Oh, we're running around.
You guys are down.
However,
when I look at the two sets of matches, I love all six.
Okay.
That top row is unbeatable.
Let's go. Let's go.
The Wolf Pucks.
Let's go.
Pucks.
Yeah,
pucks.
Good one.
Cinnamon you don't even
pucks.
Know their name.
No, it's not a great name. They didn't win a point for that.
There you go.
The Wolf Pups.
You still got the lead, though. The Beef Dogs has held us down.
I just can't.
Now, guys, we're going to have to agree on a head-to-head. We're running low on time. There's less than 30 minutes left in this show. Already half the show is gone.
Okay.
Who do you want represented in a head-to-head? Do you have a pitch, Pappolla?
The
Pappolla pitch.
You know, I love a good alliteration. Mr. Breakker, we are proposing The Undertaker for our heads.
It's about time.
Oh, come on, man. Come on, man.
Yeah, man. There he is.
And who do you have to combat him?
We do have Doink on our roster.
Doink rules.
And Doink.
Don't forget, there's two head-to-heads.
Which Doink do you have? Do you have the original?
The first.
We have the original Doink.
The first Doink. There is no other Doink.
Sam's big on original.
Love the original.
First Doink. Who could the Undertaker's opponent be? Who would you suggest?
The wild thing about the rest of our list is, funny enough, the Undertaker's beaten most of them on this list at WrestleMania. Except.
Except.
One Andre the Giant. So we're throwing Andre the Giant in our head-to-head against The Undertaker at WrestleMania. Yes, you ran through about 20 people. Andre the Giant, not one of them.
Accepted?
I love the graphic. Yeah, I mean, we care about the WWE universe.
I was hoping you were going to throw him or Yokozuna up.
I mean, Yoko, we
okay, there it is.
We saw the result of that, you know what I mean? Yeah. Royal Rumble, casket, flies into the air, gives me nightmares.
Well, you would have got an automatic
Remember,
from Sam, because it was Bloodline. Really.
This is true. I mean, hey, listen, Bloodline rules.
You know, I'm just get another.
I'm just frustrated, man.
Look at that.
I just feel like.
You got to get your boy in check. Look at that graphic.
Come on, man.
It's official.
Print the tickets.
The Undertaker.
Print the tickets.
Versus Andre the Giant. The Undertaker, of course, representing the Wolf Pups.
Yes.
And Andre the Giant representing the Beef Dogs.
Anything else to pick, right?
For our second head-to-head.
Okay.
Is there one that you guys would like to start with?
I think, you know.
Let's see who they throw
on. What are we doing?
That's.
Big who fella you or Benito?
Who needs to be okay,
that's
on my show?
That would be, I mean, no, that one.
Right? Okay,
that
of course.
That would be my choice. Who's
I like
your?
That. I, like that.
I agree with you.
Oh, right, that's where we're going.
All right, so,
right.
Like all right, so we got one person we're going to throw out there because obviously he is a WrestleMania veteran, legend, multiple-time world champion. But some people are WrestleMania champions. Some people also have the star power outside of the ring as well. We're throwing in one Batista.
Batista knocking on the cabin door.
He said star power outside of the ring didn't matter when you guys.
In this situation, we're bagging
on Austin. You guys need to figure out which road you're going down.
Well, I'm gonna tell you this
because we were bringing up all of Stone Cold's outside the ring activities, and it was like, well, we're just talking about.
I just saw Doom 2, and it was phenomenal. So I'm just rolling with my man Batista in this one.
You love Batista.
Doom 2 was fire. Guardians of the Galaxy.
Okay, these are, again, our movies.
Fire.
These are
Drax
not.
Drax is awesome. These Drax no
is,
argument.
Drax is destroying.
Sure.
It's phenomenal.
Right.
Me? We are going to throw out as our suggestion for the head-to-head against Batista, Macho Man Randy Savage.
Ooh.
Wow, and do you guys accept? Everybody accepts.
That would be a great match.
That would be a phenomenal match. As a fan.
Glad we thought of it.
As a fan, as us working together. That's an incredible match right there. My God.
That was maybe a miss. That would have been better.
Yeah. But once the bell rang, it would go downhill fast.
I kind of feel like Macho, I guess.
You're not.
Sam, is our work
Sam,
done
is there,
at this
is there,
point?
I think he's definitely our, yeah.
If you accept that final head-to-head,
so
if you
I want to work with you here. I want to make the best match possible.
Yeah.
I want to make the best match possible.
Absolutely.
All right?
I think we're going to make a change.
We have Seth freaking Rollins waiting here against the Macho Man Randy Savage.
What if they replace Batista with Seth Rollins?
That's
do you accept?
That's a lot of pomp and circumstance. I feel like they have a lot of their careers sort of mirror each other a little bit. You know, I feel like the match itself might be a little bit more of that oomph than Batista and Macho Man Randy Savage. I'm willing to work with you here. We know we got the star power.
Yeah.
But let's put together a fire match together. What does that look like?
I think that match would be sick.
Yeah, we're all about diplomacy. We're all about friendship.
We're trying to please the people.
Yeah,
and
of course.
Mr. Roberts here.
I say
putting
we do
smiles
it.
On people's faces.
That's what it's all about at the end of the day.
Yeah.
I'm with it.
That's beautiful.
That's it.
Kaz, thank you.
Come on, we go.
Let's see how that
I
looks.
Can't Watch wait man. To see what this looks like. We're going with the Macho Man, Randy Savage.
Great work, everyone.
That
great work.
Versus wow. Seth freaking Rollins. Yeah. Oh, this looks absolutely gorgeous. Now it's time to see what this show might look like. So,
how many points are up
Sam,
for
remember
grabs
who butters your bread over here, all right?
My bread is always buttered, regardless of where I go. We still have two head-to-head points up for grab.
Yes.
One main event point up for grab, and one negative point for not making the show.
Oh, my gosh. Okay. All right, that's fine.
So we are going to open again. So what you want, what you want is the main event.
Right.
Oh, what you don't want is to not make the show.
Okay. All right. Let's do it.
So we're going to open this show with, I think, the only choice.
How are we kicking the doors open, Sam? Talk to me.
Seth Rollins versus Macho Man.
All right.
Perfect.
We're both in the game.
Starts the show. I mean, this is really the follow that match of Ultimate WrestleMania 4 Sunday. Look at this. These two come out. And again, we're seeing Seth Rollins, who's not so impressed with the tradition of it all, who is fighting for his generation, for his people, a similar Seth Rollins to the Seth Rollins we've seen step up to The Rock. Of course, the Macho Man Randy Savage is in Macho Man zone all the time. Okay, and he is going to give Seth a run for his money.
You know, so who's getting the most run of their money is the seamstress between these two.
Well, it's yes.
A couple days leading up to the match.
A lot of sewing going on.
And
you know
that's
what I mean?
The other thing. We see Seth.
And I see the dry hair flying. And Rollins' hair is out to here. Macho Man, it's going to be good.
Seth is dressed to the nines more than ever because you're right, Kaz. He wants to show up the Macho Man Randy Savage, but the Macho Man Randy Savage is, of course, spending his time making sure he can show up Seth Rollins in the ring. So what we get is just a classic opening WrestleMania match. Just back and forth, back and forth. None of these guys, I mean, nothing will tire these guys out. The pace at which they move is absolutely, I mean, it leaves all of us awestruck.
You can't call it.
Seth starts the match in charge, going like, yep, you're out of your league. You're not up to the standards of today. But he doesn't realize that the Macho Man Randy Savage lasts. Yeah. The Macho Man Randy Savage stays to it. Seth starts turning around. Yeah, he starts doing this. And this is from a different era than Seth Rollins is used
to.
So Macho Man starts coming back with that psychotic offense, the likes of which you've never seen before. He finally does get, he hits that standing double axe handle. Seth goes down. Cover, one, two, kick out. Can't get him. Goes up to the top rope. We're going to see it. Double fingers in the air.
Oh, yeah.
Flying elbow. Hits it.
Let's go.
Flying elbow.
Let's go.
One more. That's not enough.
Oh, come on now.
One more. Flying elbow up on top rope. Fingers are in the air. Off the top rope with the elbow. Seth gets the knees up that time.
Let's go.
On the second elbow, Seth gets the knees up.
Yes.
Desperation. I get it.
And this is where
WrestleMania.
Now.
We're reaching down deep.
We've seen Randy Savage, God bless him, make mistakes in big matches. He tried to cover Yokozuna in 1993, got himself eliminated from the Royal Rumble, okay? Macho Man is sometimes just, he's on fire, and he can't control himself. This is
madness.
One of those scenarios. Because as Seth...
That was a terrible impression.
It was not good. As Seth...
I wouldn't have insulted you like that.
You're working yourself up to a
point.
Is finding his way up. Macho Man is getting his way up, but those ribs are hurting him. Yeah. Because all the damage that he took earlier in the match is starting to catch up with him again. And just as Macho is getting to his feet, what happens... Stomp!
That's right.
But it's Macho.
It's WrestleMania, Sam.
Macho gets stomped down.
Yeah.
Goes for the cover. One, two. Macho kicks out.
Let's go.
Macho starts hulking up again. He whips him against the rope. He goes down for the, you know, back body drop.
There you go.
Seth catches him. Pedigrees him. Covers him. One, two.
It's WrestleMania.
Three.
Yes!
Seth Rollins defeats the Macho Man Randy Savage.
1 point. Let's go.
And that is 1 point.
We're on the board, baby.
In this head-to-head battle.
4-2?
Come on now. Golly.
For the Beef Dogs.
Well, 4 points from?
It's going to be. Well, they've played very, very well so far. You have points for the money and for having the best three matches. So
I don't know what you're talking about with the first thing.
We get.
I can't believe
I could have zelled you, Sam. We should be a 5-1.
On a back body drop to pedigree?
With come a stomp on, first.
Stomp?
It was all about the comeback and then.
That's terrible.
I thought it was a wonderful choice.
I appreciate that.
That was great.
You did?
I think if we have time on the back end, we should revisit it.
Okay. If we have time. I don't know if we have time.
I don't know. The match has already happened, so like, why are we going to go back and why is he disrespecting you, man? This is your show.
I wouldn't call it disrespect.
I wouldn't.
I really appreciate that. We have to get to match two. We have to get to match two. And also, by the way, you do have to have these finishes where you never know when the match is going to end.
True.
Right?
Sure.
Right? And that's one of those instances. Well, I'm sure we'll see that match again because the second.
To me, Sam. I enjoyed it.
Okay, check. I appreciate that.
Thanks,
I appreciate that.
Thanks, Cass.
Flattery will get you everywhere.
Appreciate
the next match up is, of course, Rhea Ripley and Chyna versus Becky and Trish. And this is, I love this match.
All right, we're not.
I love this story going into this match. Right. I love that Trish has been kind of the queen of the ultimate WWE. Until Rhea Ripley came in and said, no, I'd like to take that throne from you.
Yeah.
And it was back and forth a little bit until this allyship formed, until Chyna and Rhea Ripley became a unit, and then Trish was no match for the two of them. And we saw it week after week, the beatdowns would occur, until the man, Becky Lynch, finally came through, helped out Trish Stratus. A team was formed, and here we are at Ultimate WrestleMania 4 Sunday.
What a journey.
What a journey. So the match begins.
Probably a point for that alone. But.
I mean, I feel like
and you could, we don't just give out these points willy-nilly. The match begins.
It's a good match.
And it's a great match. And, of course, it starts with, I mean, utter brutal physicality. These two are just beating down Becky and Trish. Trish is starting out there. Becky is reaching for the tag. Rhea and Chyna won't let it happen. Quick tags, power moves, until, of course, eventually Becky Lynch is able to get the tag. She comes in there, house on fire, boom, 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 boom. But she's just one person. Still not enough. They're able to take her down again. Eventually, after Becky is not able to mount that offense, Trish is able to recover. She comes back strong. Becky and Trish are able to get the victory.
Let's go.
Really? Wow.
Over Chyna and Rhea Ripley. We need a feel-good moment.
Team over Peter. Team leather.
After that.
No point for that?
Team leather.
There's no points on that one.
No, no.
What would you get? That's your match.
It's your match.
You already got a point.
Good job there.
You're on the card.
There's a good chance for a tag match.
If you keep talking about points, I'm taking a point away.
Yeah, man.
It's not about the points.
First time we're doing like this. I just wanted to make sure I understood the rules.
Hey, you got 17 minutes. Let's get to the next match.
You're right.
It's all about putting together the Ultimate WrestleMania. Gosh darn it.
Coming in at match number 3, we're going to try to steal the show one more time. It's a triple.
Let's go.
We're
all over the place here. We're all over the place.
Ultimate Intercontinental Championship is on the line. And keep in mind, that's two for you.
That's two for you.
You're not
start mathing it up.
Are you feeling good?
Start mathing it up. Feels like we're in a good spot.
No way do you keep
I want to see how this match goes.
And them off the card.
Shawn Michaels versus Razor Ramon. Versus AJ Styles, triple threat.
At this point,
ladder match. Which one,
man? They seem a little nervous over there. No,
we're not. Get left
they got
off
seven
the card.
Matches. They got their two in already. We got three more.
We've seen the type of things that Shawn and Razor can do in a ladder match. Mm-hmm. But I want you to fast forward in time. Don't think about WrestleMania 10, Shawn Michaels. Think about WrestleMania 25. Think about WrestleMania 26.
Think about this. We're telling.
Think about the stories and the evolution of Shawn. Think about the dives that he was taking then. Yes. Think about the risks that he was taking then. And I want you to then combine that with the things that AJ Styles does in on a week in, week out basis.
Yeah.
Okay, because we start this match off again fairly evenly paced. Nobody going for the ladders yet. Just all three superstars testing each other. Of course, Razor Ramon is that power base that's also coming with that with the speed, the explosivity, the athleticism that you wouldn't expect from a man of his size, and that coolness factor. Razor is able to take both Shawn and AJ out. He's the first one to get a ladder in the ring. He's the first one to start climbing. Because let's be honest,
he's a bad guy.
He's a bad guy. Yeah. He's here to win a title. He's not here to put on a show for everybody. But of course, AJ and Shawn won't have that. They realize what's happening, and as Razor's climbing up that ladder, Sean's on one apron, AJ's on another apron. Whoopoom!
Oh. Double Spider-Man?
Of course they do.
Double Spider-Man on the
ladder. And that's the moment that Razor Ramon realizes, ooh, this is not a fight that I'm prepared to deal with. Now, with Razor out of commission, the fans are going nuts, and Sean and AJ now look at each other and go, oh, it's on now. And we get this spectacle between Shawn Michaels and AJ Styles. This is what everybody was looking for. And they do use the ladder, but not necessarily to try to climb and grab the title, to jump off of it, to dive off of it. Okay. Of course, Shawn, we remember the slingshots into the ladder stuff. Yeah. Shawn's real good at using that ladder, putting his body on it, using his body weight to knock it down on AJ Styles. And as they're going, Razor's getting back in the mix and kind of using the big power to slam the ladder and everything like that until we finally get to the climax.
Okay.
Two ladders are in the ring now.
Two.
Well, see, Shawn and AJ.
Same size ladders?
Same size ladders.
Okay.
Shawn and AJ have started climbing. And Razor's seen that. Razor's smart. Instead of going, oh, let me try to tip that ladder over, Razor's realizing we're almost done. He slides the ladder in himself, puts a ladder up right next to him, and he starts climbing. He's taller than they are.
Yeah.
So he's got that reach. He's able
to climb. Seven,
and they all get to the top. So there's three of them. All on top at the same time, slugging it out. Eventually, they slug Razor. Razor goes down. AJ and Shawn are going. Knock each other out. Razor realizes they're both down. Razor climbs the ladder. Razor Ramon.
Great win.
wins.
Okay.
Heck of a match.
The ultimate intercontinental championship.
It makes me want to see the eventual Shawn AJ match too.
Ultimate WrestleMania 5 is going to be
It's
a good move. But what we got next, Sam?
Next up.
It's all right.
Another tag team match. This time, it's Lita and Alundra Blaze.
All right, we're on the board.
Versus Bianca Belair and Charlotte. Now, the thing here is that Bianca Belair and Charlotte have kind of asserted themselves as the dominant force in multi-generational women's competition.
Done with the 90s, Sam.
And this was something, and they kept saying that, too. That was Bianca's thing.
That's her thing.
Bianca
said, put it on a t-shirt.
We're done with the 90s. You don't even go here anymore.
That's right. We don't even go here, Alundra.
And then, no, what she was just talking to Lita, because she was thinking the late 90s.
Okay.
And then Alundra Blaze walked in and said, no. 94, 95, that's the 90s, too. You're talking about her. Now you're talking about me. So they're fighting for the fact that the 90s do, Kaz, in fact, matter. We're not quite done with the 90s. Now, the only problem here is that Bianca Belair and Charlotte don't look at themselves as dual queens. They look at themselves as individual queens. Mm-hmm. Bianca Belair considers herself at the top of the division. Charlotte considers herself at the top of the division. This is not a page that they can get on at the same time, but still, they understand they have a similar goal. They're going to go for it. So, as Alundra Blaze and Lita get in there, at first Bianca Belair and Charlotte are really able to take advantage, right? And we get to a point where the match is building and the match is building, and eventually they start mounting a bit of a comeback, but it's not enough. Bianca's able to fight them off. Charlotte starts reaching for the tag. Bianca goes, no, I got this. Mm-hmm. Charlotte doesn't like that. They try to get a pin on Bianca. Charlotte comes in and breaks it up. Bianca goes, I didn't need you to break that up. I was going to kick out of that.
Okay.
Here we go. You know,
and so as
alpha females.
At one point, Bianca gets whipped into the rope. Charlotte slaps her. Now I'm in. Okay. Now I'm going to do it. We see the same dynamic. Bianca is legitimately trying to help Charlotte. Charlotte's, I don't need your help. Well, all this is going on, of course. Lita and Alundra are able to work cohesively together as a team.
Yes.
Unfortunately for Lita and Alundra, even when Charlotte and Bianca aren't working together.
Talk about it.
When Alundra catches a KOD.
Yeah.
And Lita's stuck in the figure eight.
Yeah.
It's Charlotte and Bianca.
Come on, dog. Easy win.
Winning this match.
We done with the 90s, baby. Let's go.
Now, this is important. We're down to three matches.
Someone's getting left.
We're trying to figure out what's not making the cut.
If you leave the Undertaker out of the main event, you're
You think the Undertaker should main event?
I think Undertaker's main event.
Hey, it's a special.
The streak.
Well, that's good. The Undertaker match, because then you also have Punk Austin, and we get the points.
And then we get Roman. Roman and Triple H.
Are you about to leave the Tribal Chief off of this match?
He's not going to do that. You know, Cass. Tribal Chief.
Come on, Sam.
He's not going to do that.
The next matchup.
He's going to leave the Iron Man match off.
The next matchup.
It's too long of a show. We got to meet a time frame.
That's a good point.
Punk and Austin, right?
You see him, Punk and Stone Cold.
Yeah.
We're on there.
The next matchup. And by the way.
But yo, not the main event, though.
That's not the main event.
Not the main event.
It's not the main event.
We're in the game, Kaz. Okay.
But last I checked.
That's all three of our matches.
That's your threes. That's a point.
Let's go.
Regardless of how this goes, that is a point.
Take it.
Take that. We'll punt that.
And we're now at 4-3.
Math is not your strong
subject. Take the point, man.
We're only up one now.
4-3.
Listen.
The arena is silent. Nobody knows what match is coming next. No, everybody's like, oh, man, that women's tag was great. What's next? There's a breath. And everybody goes nuts. Here comes CM Punk, and this is I know, right? I'm trying to set the ambiance. This is not happy to be back, CM Punk. This is not the CM Punk that we've seen where it's like, you know what? I'm happy to be ending my career in the right place. This is CM Punk, like, I got something to prove.
Okay.
This is CM Punk, like, I don't like people going, man, CM Punk is the best guy since Stone Cold Steve Austin. No. He's there to put that to bed and beat the Texas Rattlesnake, of course. And he doesn't even like that he's the one has to come out first. Yeah. He thinks he should be the one coming out second. But no, Stone Cold doesn't play that game, because when the glass shatters, the ultimate stadium goes absolutely bonkers. And here comes Stone Cold Steve Austin. And of course, CM Punk meets him halfway through the ramp. And they just start going to blows. They ring the bell, but the referee's lost all control altogether. We're not even counting. We're not going for disqualifications. They are just brawling and going to town, both of them. have something to prove. They go around the outside of the ring. Stone Cold is he's taking drinks from fans and throwing them at Punk.
I like
Punk doesn't like that either because he's straight edge.
Yeah, that's true.
Okay, and he doesn't know what's in this drink that's being thrown at him.
He's a big kid.
I got hit in the face with a Guinness one time. Getting hit in the face with a beer during a match is not fun.
Not good. Not good.
In Philly. Very WrestleMania 13 vibes.
Very much. Very much. Stone Cold takes the chair right out from under Michael Cole. Right, Michael Cole falls right down on his behind as Stone Cold starts wailing on CM Punk with the chair. CM Punk escapes into the ring, and now it's time to get the thing started. Yeah. Right, as CM Punk gets into the ring, you'd think he's escaping in a cowardly fashion, but
Shut up.
Because as Stone Cold rolls into the ring, CM Punk just starts putting the boots to him immediately. This is where CM Punk is able to come back. He's able to use so much of that unique offense that Punk has to get ahead of Stone Cold Steve Austin. The match goes on, there's brawling. Hits Stone Cold with a go to sleep. Covers him, 1-2, kick out. No way. CM Punk is like, oh, I can't believe it. His hair is all mussy, he's sweating. Yep. He's put everything he has into this match. Yeah. He gets up, he's looking at the ref, he's like, what are we doing? He was down for three. He turns around, boot to the midsection, stunner. Punk goes halfway up to the ceiling, comes back down. Austin covers him, 1-2, kick out.
All right, it's WrestleMania.
And now we've reset. Yeah. Now we're looking at each other like, okay, now we're on to something. The brawl starts again. Punk's using those knees because, you know, Austin he doesn't have those knees like Punk has. He's getting them up high, knocking Austin. Austin stuns Punk again, 1-2, Punk kicks out. Austin goes,
two
what?
Stunners?
He goes out of the ring. Yes. He goes to get a chair. He brings the chair in the ring. Punk's waiting for him, kicks him in the midsection. GTS, 1-2-3. CM Punk beats Stone Cold Steve Austin.
All right.
Heck of a match.
CM Punk beats Stone Cold Steve Austin.
You're so good at this.
Thank you.
4 years, man. 4 years.
You can't believe that happened, Bron Breakker?
Not really.
It's a little.
It's real, dude.
Listen.
It's real. It happened.
I banged with CM Punk, like, man. But, yo.
It happened.
I do, too, right? Punk is great.
Right, but.
Love Punk. Austin at WrestleMania.
Awesome.
Man.
Well, let's see what happens.
Come on, dude.
Let's see what happens.
How are we gonna drink beer after the match?
He'll still drink.
How are we gonna beer bash after the match? We're not, because he lost.
They go to shake hands, and Austin stuns him, calls for beers.
Yeah.
We're in business.
Out of respect. You know what? And we don't have that long for a beer celebration because this isn't the main event. Don't forget, there's points to be given in the main event. Coming up next.
Ring crew.
It's time to play the game.
Wow, Sam.
I like this.
Triple H walks to the ring, and there's things over here from Terminators. There's things over here maybe from that movie Gremlins.
Yes.
There's things over there. There's a helicopter from True Lies. There's
Thor
just,
hammers.
I mean, it's the most, Thor hammers. He's got a throne that's been pasted back together. I don't know who smashed that thing. It's an amazing scene. That's Triple H.
All of a sudden, it's about a lot of outside the ring stuff.
Wait, that's the entrance. First of all, I said that for you in your favor. What are you?
I'm not saying. That was your favor.
What number match is that for us?
This is our second match.
Semi main.
Second out of three. This is semi main.
Semi main.
Semi main. And of course,
I still like our chances at our triple.
I don't know if we are because they have the Undertaker.
After all that pomp, don't forget you got a long triple threat match.
That's a big triple threat, man. Yeah.
After all that pomp and circumstance. After all that pomp and circumstance for Triple H, the string section comes out. The whole damn orchestra.
Yes.
Here comes
that's
Roman Reigns.
That's a piano that makes that sound.
No, I think it's a violin.
Down to 4.5 minutes.
Pretty sure it's a violin. So, no, a violin. So,
what are you doing?
You can do it on a violin. So, Roman comes out. He meets Triple H. Triple H is, of course, unimpressed. This is the same Triple H. This is the type of Triple H we saw not only with Roman Reigns at 32, but even before that. This is Triple H who fought The Undertaker. This is ultimate Triple H, but Roman is unimpressed as well. The two of them, they're going at it. And Triple H is taking advantage of this match a lot.
Okay.
He's getting a lot of play. He's playing all the hits. He's getting that high knee in. He pedigrees Roman at one point. Roman kicks out of the pedigree.
We've already seen a pedigree tonight, though.
Hey, but not like his.
That didn't end in a kick out. Roman is just about beat. And what happens?
He didn't think that all the way through when he
here comes the bloodline.
Ultimate Solo Sikoa comes out. Spikes Triple H in the neck.
Let's go.
Roman Reigns hits him with one of the best spears in the business.
That's right.
And pins Triple H. 1-2-3. Bloodline reigns supreme. Now, it all boils down to this with a score of 4-3 with the Beef Dogs on top.
Come on.
Come on, Sam.
The main event of this show.
Are you going to keep Bret Hart off of Ultimate WrestleMania, Sam?
Cass, now's not the time to try that.
I know you, Sam.
I was listening the whole time.
I know you, Sam.
We're going to lose this one.
And you said, Braun.
I did say this. You know what? I did.
The Undertaker cannot be left off.
They came up 45 times.
WrestleMania.
The Undertaker's on their team. He should be in the main event. We lose a point. Cool. Undertaker should be in the main event.
This man cares about the fans, all right? He cares about putting on a great show.
So we're taking it off the main event of the Ultimate WrestleMania Sunday 4 is The Undertaker versus Andre the Giant. Wolf pups, beef dogs, head to head.
Yes.
Now, with that announcement made, the beef dogs just lost a point.
What?
The score is now 3-3 because
your match didn't make the card.
You didn't make the card.
Oh. Didn't make the card.
However, nobody gets points for main event. So what's going to happen? The winner of this head-to-head gets two.
Oh my goodness! Oh,
which means,
so it's winner take all. You only need one to win at this
winner
point.
Winner take all.
It's tied up.
You want to win two. By one, or you want to dominate?
Good point.
Whatever you'd like, good sir.
Got to win by two. You got to win by two.
Hey.
It's like are you trying to tell him how to run his own show?
You got
to
run that scoreboard.
I literally said whatever you want.
Cool, bro.
I said whatever you want.
I also question the logic of a team agreeing to a head-to-head points battle with the Undertaker on another team
that they put over the
knowing what the Undertaker does at WrestleMania.
Listen.
I will tell you this. Okay. If it were me, I would probably not allow an opposing team to put the Undertaker on a show. Unless I just wanted to give him a point. But we don't know how this is going to go.
99.2% of the time at WrestleMania.
Andre the Giant
wins 99.2% of the time in life. He's only lost like two matches ever.
And where was one of them?
WrestleMania.
We're not worried about details right now. I think
The Undertaker walks to the ring. He's got gray gloves on.
Pun intended.
I think we respect.
They dug their own grave.
Gray tie. This is old school Undertaker. Undertaker gets a beating the entire match because Andre the Giant is absolutely unstoppable. Headbutts him. 1-2, kick out. Big boot, 1-2, kick out. Finally, he gets a big splash. The Undertaker's not moving. Paul Bearer lifts that urn in the air. The Undertaker sits up.
Yep.
You were thinking of WrestleMania 3. I'm thinking of WrestleMania 6. Jake the Snake Roberts and Andre the Giant. Baby. Andre running away from that snake. That's the way Andre ran away from the dead man. Coming back to life. Because when he does, it's uppercut. It's uppercut. It's uppercut. The Giant is staggered. Old school. Twist the arm.
Old school,
walks the ropes. Boom. While he's staggered. You thought Hogan slamming Andre was amazing? Scoop.
Let's go.
Andre's up.
Get to the finish, man.
Tombstone. The Undertaker wins. And the Beef Dogs take it 5-3. Thank you for watching another episode of The Ultimate Show.
This is all your fault, Bron. I gotta say.
It is my fault.
Wow, they're turning on each other over there.